Hey guys, I'm Cole Weaver, and this is part four of this series, How to Build Your Own Alarm Radio Clock. And we're gonna start the actual work on the PCB in this episode. We're gonna solder everything, and I'm gonna show you how I wrote the firmware. So make sure to smash that like button, and just take a moment and subscribe to the channel. If you want a chance to win one of the five copies of the PCB, which I'm giving away, just leave a comment, tell me which part of this series have you enjoyed the most. Just want to add thank you guys for all your support. You guys are the best audience on YouTube. Thanks again, each and every one of you. And with that being said, let's get this. All right, so I'm testing the radio for the first time, and unfortunately, I made the decision to remove the sounds for this segment. I didn't want to risk a copyright infringement. I wasn't sure if you're allowed to play your radio music, and it's kind of stupid to make a video of a radio you've built and you're not able to test it properly because there's music playing on every radio station. Sorry for that, but I don't make these rules. You just have to trust me that the sound is amazing. It's crystal clear. In fact, that's one more reason to build one and see for yourself. So I was telling you earlier, there are several pieces of software and tools I created for this project. So first we have our microcontroller's firmware. Then we have a tool for creating custom characters, which we're going to use in our firmware. And then we have a PC application which we're going to use to add or remove radio stations. And I did this because I wanted to make it possible for everyone to add his own radio channels. They're not pre-programmed in the firmware. If I would have chosen that path to set the name of the radio channels and their frequencies in the firmware, then you would have had to recompile the firmware. It's obvious, right? If you're living in Los Angeles and you have a bunch of stations from Florida or from Sweden, they're useless to you. So instead of forcing everyone to modify and recompile the firmware, I chose to create this UART tool. It's very simple to use. You just have to establish a serial communication between your PC and the radio clock, and then you can add your own radio stations. I'm going to show you the firmware first. The whole thing is written in BASIC. I'm giving you the source code too. It is open source like everything else in this project. You can easily port this on other languages. If you know C or assembler, then you most probably won't have any problem to read BASIC and to translate it. Just make sure to give proper credit if you distribute this and support my channel in any way you can. That's all I'm asking for. So here's the declaration part. I'm not going to go through each line of code. I'm just giving you an overview of the whole thing. So I'm using two timers, one for the backlight of the display, which we're going to dim after a while using pulse width modulation. And the second timer is used to manage the alarm events. The RTC chip, the DS1307, doesn't have an alarm output pin, so I have to do this to implement this in software. You can see here the addresses of the RTC chip and the radio module. They're both sharing the I2C for the communication with the AVR. And then the temperature sensors, they're both using the one wire protocol. You can use only one sensor if you don't want to measure the temperature outside. The AVR will look for these sensors after reset. You can have either one of these sensors, two of them, or no temperature sensor at all. Here's where I'm defining my special LCD characters to draw each digit of the clock to appear as if it was a 7-segment display. I have a lot of variables and constants. That's why these high values for the hardware stack, software stack, and the frame size. Then I have all these procedures and functions. And here's where the main code starts. This section here is where we're looking for the temperature sensors, then dimming the LCD's backlight, and then we go into this main loop here. We're instructing the AVR to keep asking the RTC what time is it, and watching for any alarm event. And while we're doing this, we're forming the digits for the clock and then display the time on the LCD. If an alarm has been detected, we call this subroutine. And also in this main loop, we're monitoring any key presses or combinations. Some of the actions require a long key press or two keys to be pressed at the same time. For instance, here, if I press the radio key, I'm turning on the LCD backlight. Then I start the timer because we want to dim the backlight back to zero after a while. And then I switch the radio on or off. But if I'm pressing the set key at the same time, so I'm keeping both of these keys pressed, I'm performing a whole different function. In this case, I'm switching between two modes of LCD illumination. The LCD's backlight can be always on or set to automatically dim after a while. If the radio is on and I press either the plus key or the minus key, that will change the radio station. If the radio is off and I press one of these plus or minus keys, I'm showing either the current date and the measured temperatures or the time when an alarm is set. I can also adjust or fine-tune the frequency of any radio station. I can increase or decrease the value in very small steps. If I press this tune key while the radio is off, we're entering the UART mode, which allows me to communicate with the PC application to add or remove radio stations. Then pressing the set key allows me to modify the time and the date. So you see, each one of these actions is basically a submenu. Everything is visible on the LCD, and in some cases I also have UART feedback for debugging purposes. And here's my snooze button. It's my favorite button in this whole project. That's why it's so big. You can't miss it. A long press is going to disable the alarm, and a normal press is going to give me 5 more minutes to sleep before the alarm will start again. And this sequence repeats 3 times. So if I'm not up in 15 minutes and I manage to ignore the alarm, then it will let me sleep. It won't bother me again till the next day. There are different types of signaling an alarm. I can choose between turning on the radio when the alarm starts, so I'll wake up with some music, or I can use the piezo buzzer to make that annoying noise everyone knows, or I can use a somehow silent alarm. It will only start blinking the LCD. And you can use that if you don't want to wake up your wife or the cat or the dog, if you're like me and don't want that level of activity in the morning. The alarm can be also completely disabled. So the code is pretty complex. I used almost the entire flash memory of the microcontroller, and I tried to implement all the necessary functions to make this as useful as possible. So if you decide to build your own, hopefully you will fall in love with this, and there are great chances you're not going to want to buy an alarm clock or radio ever again.